And Czech small arms of VZ-58 keeps plowing forward, slowly but steady. Again, guys, this is absolutely freaking amazing rifle. I rarely say this when shooting a rifle, because it kind of sounds silly, right? But this VZ-58 really hits my sweet spot. It is fun to shoot. Everyone, whoever comes and I let the people shoot that rifle, they are extremely pleased and happy with it. Low recoil, extremely accurate, and it delivers every time when you pull that trigger. What else you can ask for, right? And it has that calm black spirit or Cold War spirit. If you're looking for a collectible to add to your collection and you are on the borderline about the VZ-58 from the Czech Small Arms, you can get it in a classic setup with the wood furniture all over the place. Go get it. Guys, at this point, I know we are not done yet, and unless something horrible will happen, but I'm telling you, it is absolutely worth it. I paid, if I remember correctly, it was like $1,200 with XMX, and it was absolutely worth it. I'll do it again. Rarely, I'm telling you, rarely, I feel like this was a good purchase and I didn't overpay. This is the case where I think the price is right. The quality is outstanding. This rifle shoots the lights out. If you haven't watched the separate episode, you could see we took it to the 500 yards, and it shoots and delivers with 7.62x39 cheap ammo. Guys, we're using in this episode, for this episode, we ran everything, any kind of mixture of ammo I could came up with. We had the hollow points, we had the Wolf ammo, we had the Wolf full metal jacket, we had the Wolf hollow points, we had the full metal jackets from Tula, and of course we had the full metal jacket from Barnaul. So any kind of ammo this rifle cycles. One addition in this episode, you probably noticed already, I have a left side charging handle, and some people were saying when I posted the pictures on Instagram and Facebook that this is rather kind of getting in the way or hitting you in the chest when you are holding the rifle like this. That's not the case. The Czechs are extremely smart people. Look at it's angled. I hope you can, don't freak out, there is no round in a magazine or in chamber. So you can see it's under the angle and it's preventing your body from hitting. It really, it works. I had zero problems. I'm using a sling and I can maneuver this rifle and it's absolutely working on the left side. What is interesting too, as you can see, we're continuing to shoot with our Anhilator combo for the VZ-58. By the way, yes, it is available in our store. This is the complete set with the RS Regulate lower mount and the ACOG on the top and the 3X scope. And as you can see, left side's charging handle, you can still use it because the way how the VZ is designed. So as I said, the Czech people are extremely smart. Kudos to them. The Czech Small Arms delivers. I absolutely like what they do and how they do it, guys. They are really, they take time, and this is the quality piece. A lot of questions about those clear magazines. Magazines are holding up very nicely. As I said, there is no metal reinforcements in those new Czech Small Arms magazines, but I did the push-ups with them. I had few drops off record. This was the different part of the test, but they absolutely hold up, and maybe you don't need that those metal reinforcements on those magazines. I don't know yet. All I'm saying is, so far I did not see any issues with it, and maybe that's because how these lock, how they lock into the VZ. It's slightly different than AK. So far so good. Those magazines do deliver. Very cool. They are awesome. They are only I got them from the Czech Small Arms, guys. So that's the only site where you can get them. If someone else is selling, I'm sorry that I didn't. I just don't know. I got them from Czech Small Arms. So that's what I'm passing to you guys. All right, time to dig in. Right, time to dig in. Inside, let me take off the Anhilator combo, go to the side. Okay, got dust cover off. Oh, of course I dropped the bolt, but that's okay, because it is solid piece of quality from Czech Republic. All right, we'll start with a so-called bolt carrier and the striker. Everything here is looking great, guys. They are just regular wear off marks. This is what I would expect. There is no damage, and this is that left side charging handle on it. But I kept the same bolt, and we can keep rotating and switching if you want to, but the old one, you see on the pictures, there's absolutely no damage or anything. I just wanted to show you off that the left one, that they got the left one, and it's a quality piece as well. So let me see how the extractor claw, because this is okay. The extractor claw is looking great, very good extraction, solid extraction, no issues whatsoever. Firing pin is looking tip. I can see it through the peep hole, looking good too. And I do not see anything unusual on this, neither on that piece as well. Let me check the recoil springs. They're looking good too, guys. So this is looking good. Look inside the receiver. As you can see, we're gaining some scratches, and that's perfectly normal. The rifle is getting used. That's normal, guys. The same here up front a little bit, and receiver. But other than this, receiver and the barrel are looking, in the chamber are looking perfectly fine. The few notes about that trigger. If you can, I would swap out that trigger. If we wouldn't be testing it, I would swap out that that polymer trigger. I don't like the feel of it. It kind of, you know, feels funky. So if you're buying, and I know there are basically off aftermarket triggers, metal triggers, I'll definitely do that. And of course, we got here from the beginning the adapter for the Yugo Zhukov stock, and this is working great with the cheek riser for the 3x scope. This is my favorite setup, really. It works great, guys. Let me pull out gas tube. I mean, not the gas tube. Okay, here is the crippled pirate. It's not the gas tube. This is the old habit from the AK. This is basically a piston cover, guys. And no damages or anything. This is looking great too. And as you can see, this is that piston and piston head. All here is looking perfectly fine. It's just dirty. This is what you expect. I'll pull out that spring, don't want to lose it. Look into the gas block. Everything here is looking great. Guys, I'm telling you, this thing is holding up like there's no tomorrow. Absolutely fun to shoot. And in my eyes, at this point, and unless something will happen, I'm telling you, this is going to be outstanding performance. This muzzle device at the end, this is the original Czech Small Arms muzzle device, very effective, no recoil. Even my little one, when she's shooting, she is enjoying it. Everyone is enjoying shooting this rifle. So far, so good. Czech Small Arms, I think we're going to clear you guys to go to the next round. Stay tuned for the updates on the rifle. No-go gauge express setup for a VZ58. All ready? She shakes the head, she's ready, let's go. Look at that, guys, nothing, poetry. You cannot close it, boom. And one more time, let's try to put some pressure. No way, that's how we like it. All right, so rifle is officially cleared for another 1,000 rounds. Let's roll.